As the most populous mammalian species on the planet, it's no surprise that humans of all backgrounds and cultures have come up with some creative ways to spice things up in the bedroom. But turns out we're not the only ones with certain types of kinks. In fact, some species out there have mating rituals that are so bizarre, disgusting, or downright disturbing, they make even the kinkiest ideas we've come up with seem normal. So if you're of the squeamish type, I'd prepare yourself, because in this video, we're talking about the worst animal mating rituals on Earth. Despite being slow and disgusting, and leaving slime everywhere they go, snails have an incredibly competitive and aggressive mating ritual. These slimy slowpokes have turned mating into a real-life remake of dodgeball, but with reproductive organs as the dodgeballs. Snails are hermaphroditic, meaning they have both male and female sexual organs. What essentially happens is both snails will engage what can be described as a jousting match. They will both shoot each other with calcified darts to try and penetrate the other's flesh and impregnate them first. And whichever snail that is loses their male function, essentially being inseminated against its will. We humans think of such a thing as utterly barbaric and contemptible, but for snails, that's just a day in the life. Oh, and these matches can go on for hours until the winner fertilizes the loser. Yep, we're starting off on an interesting note. Some dysfunctional relationships have a partner that can be best described as a parasite, a drain on resources while barely contributing anything to the relationship. But the mating rituals of anglerfishes make that quite literal. Female anglerfishes are much larger than males. Remember the one from Finding Nemo? That was a female anglerfish, albeit obviously exaggerated. Male anglerfish are significantly smaller and spend their lives swimming aimlessly until they encounter a female. If they don't, well, they simply perish. The ones that do find a female latch onto her body with their teeth and release an enzyme that digests their own body and fuses the pair together permanently. The male is essentially reduced to a sperm-dispensing organ permanently attached to the female. As messed up as this obviously seems to us humans, this anglerfish male asserting his entire existence just to be a sperm delivery system is really just playing the Piscean version of the biological imperative we all follow. But, you know, male humans can obviously say that they're much more useful than male anglerfish. At least the ones who decide to make themselves useful are. Hey you, do you find bizarre, wacky, and disturbing facts like these interesting? If you do, we sure would appreciate you if you'd subscribe to this channel and like this video. We've got plenty more videos in the pipeline of fascinating and freaky facts like this, so you doing that lets us know you're hungry for more and keeps us inspired. Thanks in advance. And now back to the video. Bed bugs, arguably the most universally despised bugs on the planet. But besides causing you to wake up every morning with irritating bites all over your body, they have a mating ritual that is downright savage. There's no such thing as foreplay with these critters. They get straight to violation. And I do mean violation. The males jab their Johnson straight through a female's abdomen in a process politely called traumatic insemination. The male bedbug uses his charged genital to rupture the female's abdominal cavity, injecting sperm through the gaping wound directly into her body. This armored truck reproduction can cause serious injury and spread disease, but from the male's perspective, it gets the job done, as horrifically as possible. Females have evolved mild resistance, like thicker carapaces, but it's still a violating process. If you watched the Banana Splits movie, you might remember the surprise circumcision scene. This is basically the bedbug's version of that. Oh, and just to add a little bit of nope icing onto this horror cake, sometimes, groups of males will gang up on one female. You should be smart enough to figure out what probably happens in these situations. Honestly, I feel like I need a shower just after this description. Moving on to the land down under where everything wants to kill you, Australian redback spiders, oh no, have a mating ritual that's about as horrifying as the spider themselves. After a relatively mundane mating session between a male and a female, the male somersaults directly into the fangs of the female to be devoured as a post-coital snack after mating. This, self-sacrifice provides the female with a nutrient-rich meal to aid in the production of offspring. It also somehow prevents competition from other males and passes more resources to his young. Boy, am I glad we humans haven't evolved to do such a thing. Well, at least those of us that are sane. But for the redback widows, well, mating is just the prelude to having your husband for dinner as an act of paternal care. Okay, I don't do spiders to begin with, so I'm done. Let's get out of here. Of all the mating rituals on this list, sardines are the one that probably take the term gangbang the most extremely. Each summer, sardines gather in the open ocean in mind-bogglingly massive numbers to spawn. This occurs when temperature and environmental conditions are just right for fertilization, sending synchronized signals to the deep water population that the hour has come to fulfill their duties to the next generation. In response, sardines migrate toward more shallow and protected nearshore waters en masse, drawing predators from far and wide. Billions of fish come together in a lurching, frenzied mass called a bait ball that can be over a mile wide. The entire shoal releases its eggs and sperm in unison, creating a swirling maelstrom of fish and gametes before quickly dispersing. Fun fact, it's one of the largest reproductive events on the planet annually. Just imagine people doing something similar. You know, actually, I think I don't want to. Oh my god. We humans are all about consent when it comes to sexual encounters. We even have laws that would punish those who would violate this concept. But when it comes to ducks, there is no such concept. Mallards are basically sexual predators. Males will literally chase down females and forcibly mate with them in horrifying gangbang scenarios. And if that wasn't horrifying enough for you, a mallard duck phallus is shaped like corkscrew augers, designed to basically drill into and damage the female's anatomy from the inside out. The females have evolved vaginas that loop into counterclockwise swirls just to make it harder for all those rapey drakes to inseminate them. You know, when your own genitals become sexual assault deterrents, you know Mother Nature screwed up on this one. From gangbanging ducks to amorous cuttlefish. As it turns out, male cuttlefish have a courtship ritual that makes Romeo seem like, well, a barbarian in comparison. To win himself a mate, he must first impress the female through an elaborate courtship display, waving his tentacles and changing colors so rapidly it could hypnotize. He'll even construct miniature aviaries and mating pavilions from materials foraged from the seafloor, such as elaborate sculptures of rock, coral, and vegetation assembled through arduous labor, all made into potential egg-laying tributes for his prospective partner to critique. If the female is suitably awed, she'll allow him to insert a specialized tentacle into her mouth to transfer the sperm. However, just like a princess being pursued by nobles, she may have several suitors after her at once, which can lead to raucous fights between the amorous males. It's a remarkable sequence of seduction rituals mastered only by the most formidable of suitors that brilliantly combines visual dynamism, architectural ingenuity, and feats of physical dexterity. Truly the most beautiful display from the cephalopodic Casanovas of the sea. And from beautiful courtship to traumatizing penis fencing. Yep, we're talking about the mating ritual of humble flatworms. And when I say penis fencing, I'm not kidding. These little horrors will unsheath their dagger-like penises and try to stab each other until one penetrates the opponent first. And whichever one is unlucky enough to get harpooned must carry and lay the other one's offspring. Pretty much taking the whole, you're the girl in this relationship, insult to extremes. Man, even the most bizarre human sexual practices outside of murder and cannibalism aren't worse than this. You know, some people have literally lost their lives from shagging, mostly due to medical issues or cultural norms that left a lot of people with sexual anxiety. But for marsupial mice, this is a pretty common occurrence. Male marsupial mice are so eager to mate that they will mate themselves into literal exhaustion during breeding season, literally depleting their bodies so much that they crash and die. It's the mustelid version of sexual binging, a multi-week orgy that ends with their furry little corpses strewn about in the afterglow. Try to imagine a bunch of little marsupial Caligulas crossed with Motley Crue, just going day after day sickeningly hard until the party kills them. It's the price of that rock and roll lifestyle. You know, some people say that their mate is possessive, often suspicious of them and wanting to control who they hang out with. Well, turns out, dragonflies have a possessive streak too. In fact, their mating practices are a study in possessive promiscuity and seminal sabotage. Male dragonflies take aggressive stances toward paternity assurance. Once a male has coupled with a fertile female, depositing his sperm within for fertilization, he remains intimately acquainted with his partner to deter any potential rivals from attempting to mate with her in turn. Should another male attempt to usurp the first one's paternity claim, the first father will employ a shocking reproductive countermeasure, utilizing an elaborate, cumbersome appendage evolved precisely for such an eventuality. The original male will forcefully attempt to evacuate his competitor's seminal payload from within its mate before it can do its physiological duty. Essentially, he performs a vigorous form of internal scrubbing, using hooked and scooped structures to physically draw out and scoop out any recently deposited rival seminal material. It's quite an extraordinarily proactive way for dragonflies to maintain genetic dominance and ensure their meteoric transcontinental flights don't spark bastard progeny along the migratory routes. But just try to imagine us people doing something similar. It'd be jail time. And our last mating ritual for the day takes dirty dancing to a whole new level. Banana slugs are among nature's most accomplished reproductive overachievers. As hermaphrodites, meaning they have both male and female organs, when two slugs mate, they entwine in a courtship dance where both transfer sperm to the other, fertilizing one another simultaneously. Seems like they believe in equality a little more than the snails we mentioned before. Oh, but if you thought that was all, no. The real show comes in trio mating events. Literal banana slug threesomes or moresomes are actually pretty common in the wild. Three or more slugs will intertwine in a shimmering trichromatic snarl, each slug inseminating their partner at the same time in a protonaceous group hug, with sperm swapped between all participants in a slimy slug threesome or orgy. Just try to imagine people doing something like this and catching it on camera. Wait, they already do? Huh. When's my shift over again? And that is the end of this video, ladies and gentlemen. I think we've sufficiently disturbed and possibly scarred a bunch of you for life with the horrors of the natural world's mating habits. But hey, at least we can all be grateful that we were born human and get to deal with more traditional romantic pitfalls like ghosting, retroactive jealousy, and emotionally stunted commitment phobes. Although if we're being honest, those can be equally as bad. It may be undeniable from a human perspective that these practices are horrifying, but the thing is, Mother Nature cares not for our morals and ethics. Out in the wild, it's about survival of the fittest, and animals must do what they must with what they were given in order to survive. But anyway, if, for some reason, you enjoyed this deranged romp through the mating misadventures of the animal kingdom, be sure to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and let us know which weird mating ritual you thought was the most interesting. Or maybe you know about an even more weird mating ritual, you deviant. Anyway, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.